Now get ready to discover my intriguing Cochin, with its wealth of historical associations and its beautiful settings on cluster of islands and narrow peninsulas. This interesting city of Cochin reflects the eclecticism of Kerala perfectly. Hi, I'm Ranjan Dey. I'm sitting on top of a mountain of black pepper. Black pepper is the king of spices, and it is available everywhere. And it comes from here in Cochin. In a moment, we'll learn more about black pepper. We'll also observe the pepper festival, appeasing goddess Vasurimal with offerings of black pepper and turmeric. Then later in the evening, have a barbecue. A poolside barbecue with Chef George. It is surprising that the use of pepper has come so much into fashion. Commodities, as a rule, attract us by their appearance or utility. But the only quality of pepper is its pungency. And yet, it is this very undesirable element that we import it in very huge quantities, said Pliny, lamenting the depletion of Roman treasury to satisfy the passion for Cochin peppers. The Phoenicians, the Arabs, the Europeans, the Chinese, and the Portuguese came one after another to the port of Cochin for this black gold, only to return time and again. Pepper auctions are done between the growers and the trading houses with a towel over their hand, so that the negotiated price does not become common knowledge to the other growers present at the auction. Each squeeze of the hand represents 40. That means one squeeze is 40, two squeezes 80. And if they hold one finger, that is 81. If they hold two fingers, that's 82. If they turn in one finger, that's 79. We are in Kudungalu, a small town about 60 miles from Cochin. This is the festival of goddess Vasurima. Do not offer her flowers during prayer. The only way to appease her is to offer her black pepper and turmeric and sing raunchy songs to make her happy. Raunchier the song, happier she is. During singing, a lot of men and women goes into trance, and the temple priests are at hand to perform rituals. This is the temple of Vasurimal, and this is goddess Vasurimal. Here we see one of the main temple priests giving blessing to the devotees. Wow, look at that huge rice cooker. I'm sure it can double as a bathtub too. Here we see a woman in trance and the temple priest conducting a ritual. Now we're off to see Chef George. I could not resist stopping here at St. Thomas Church. It is a great moment of the history of India that a fisherman called Thomas, one of the 12 disciples of Christ, followed the call of the Master. He risked his life and dared to sail to the distant shores of India. Here, at this holy land, he set up the first church in 52 AD. This church is the fifth church which has been built on the same holy land. St. Thomas performed many miracles and converted staunch higher caste Brahmins to Christians at this very pond next to the church. he went on to establish 7 other churches in south of India. We are at the Seafood Grill in Trident, Cochin with Executive Chef George. So, Chef George, we're going to do a barbecue today. So,
that's right.
Tell me what you're going to do with this black pomfret.
Well, Ranjan, as you can see, the fish is already marinated. What I have used for the marinade is black pepper, which is freshly crushed, a bit of salt, Tajam mustard, lemon juice, and oil. So, tell me, what are you going to cook for me today?
Well, I'm going to cheat. You know, right. I'm very good at it. So what I'm going to do, take some of your lemon juice, black pepper, a little bit of salt, add a little oil to it, and then cheat with the spices, New Delhi barbecue spice.
Okay.
Just smear right on it, and let's see how both of them boogies.
Okay.
How good is going to taste? Not yet. And once, we're just going to flip on both sides.
That's right.
And then you're going to have a nice, nice meal.
Absolutely.
George served the delicious barbecued fishes with glazed pineapple and garlic bread. So good.